In my lab, we try to do something that's called systems biology. So instead of looking at maybe a small part of an organism, we try to look at the whole organism at the same time. My lab consists of three graduate students, four postdocs, and right now we have eight undergrads in the lab. We work on infectious diseases, and one of the most popular, basically, bacteria that we work on in our lab is called Streptococcus pneumoniae, strep pneumo, and it kills about 1.5 million people each year. So we use it as a model organism, basically, to try to understand how antibiotics work. And this bacterium is also becoming more and more resistant against antibiotics. We can really extract very detailed information, the fundamental processes that are going on. Why that is interesting is then we can actually introduce some dynamics in the models that we create. And if you do that, you can actually start to make predictions on what kind of drugs would be the best to treat a certain infection with. So what we're going to look at is a liquid handling system. It's a robot. It's basically a box, a big box, and the box has two arms, one liquid handling arm and one robotic grabber arm. And the liquid handling arm can dispense out all kinds of liquids, and liquids could be drugs, or it could be a media that we use to grow bacteria in. And a robot can then also take those plates, stick them into an incubator. That incubator is kept at a certain temperature. And then the robot can also take those plates out of those incubators, out of those hotels, and then stick it into a plate reader. And the plate reader then takes a measurement to determine how fast these bacteria are growing, whether the drugs, for instance, that we add to these bacteria are having any effects. And then we can cycle this basically through 16 hours, so we don't really have to stay with these bacteria while they're growing. What we're trying to understand is if you have an antibiotic and if you have a bacterium and if you have the patient, what should we do with those three points in our triangle, basically? Do we first have to boost the immune system, for instance, of the patient before we treat the bacterial infection? Or can we right away treat the infection? And what kind of antibiotics do we need to use in that infection to have the immune system help in clearing the infection? Those are the major applications where we're working towards. We're getting closer. We're not there yet, but it's looking very, very promising in several parts of our research.